Help at Ace is like going to your neighbor.
The Fiat 500 isn't alone anymore. It's part of a big Italian family.
Look! This is the new Asian-inspired broth bowl from Panera Bread. Our hero is the soba noodle. Which we pair with fresh spinach.
Ah, mushrooms.
Yes. And chicken raised without antibiotics.
Very nice.
Then top with a soy miso broth. That noise! Panera broth bowls should be slurped with gusto. Yum. To explore further, order online or visit your neighborhood Panera Bread.
Attention accident victims.
If you or a loved one has been injured in any kind of accident, you may be eligible for substantial compensation. Don't wait to file your claim. Time is limited. Call now and let a local experienced attorney fight to get you money for your injuries.
If you have been injured in an accident, time is limited to file a claim, so act now. The call and consultation are free.
Call 1-800-307-9899.
Attention accident victims.
If you or a loved one has been injured in any kind of accident, you may be eligible for substantial compensation. Don't wait to file your claim. Time is limited. Call now and let a local experienced attorney fight to get you money for your injuries.
If you have been injured in an accident, time is limited to file a claim, so act now. The call and consultation are free.
Call 1-800-307-9899.
Who knew weight loss with Hydroxycut was this tasty? Hydroxycut, America's number one weight loss brand. Instantly add weight loss power to your water. Try new Hydroxycut drops.
It's time to elevate your expectations of what luxury waterfront living can be. Water Club North Palm Beach. In the heart of everything you love about the Palm Beaches. Unmatched views in every direction. Unrivaled amenities. Private club living on the water's edge. Water Club North Palm Beach, presented by Coulter. Visit our sales gallery just south of PGA Boulevard on US 1.
What does it mean to just believe? It means to live your life again, to be yourself again, to start recovering from your addiction with the help of people who have been there before and who know what you're going through. So if you're struggling with alcohol or drug addiction, don't wait another minute. Just believe. Call Just Believe Recovery today at 1-855-726-6112.
Sundays.
One man's trash.
This is perfect.
Is another man's wood-powered Jeep gasifier.
Brainstormers. Sundays at 9, only on the Weather Channel.
Where are we going? It's the white car on the other side of that gray van.
More powerful video coming in from Oklahoma. Now, we're hearing amazing stories of survival, too, after the deadly storms tore through Sand Springs, Oklahoma, including what you're seeing here. Now, a group of 60 young gymnasts inside the Aim High Gymnastics Studio narrowly escaped as a tornado caved the roof right in. So happy that everyone was able to get out safely. We're taking you back live, of course, to the Sand Springs area to follow up on the scene there. That's coming up in just a moment. But now we want to check in with Mike Bettis. He's in the lab to talk more about the wintry side of this storm.
Yeah, that's right, Viv, here with Mike Bettis, and we're talking about the fact that this is the clash of the seasons. Yeah. We still have winter off to the north, even as we're talking severe storms in the plains.
Yeah, it's pretty interesting when you see kind of the dynamics of the atmosphere, how it's all playing out. There's a warm side, there's a cold side, yeah, too. Not a ton of cold air. I mean, well, let me change that. There's not a ton of cold air producing snow, okay? There's a lot of cold air, though. Trust me when I say that. All right, there's a look at our low way up here in Canada. We're getting some strong north flow around that. We've also got a cold front kind of generally right here. And that's, you know, all advancing off to the east. So temperatures will then begin to trend about 20 degrees below average mark over the next couple of days here. In fact, all across the east.
And what's remarkable is just how warm it is out ahead of that front. I mean, it's going to be close to 75 in D.C. today.
Right.
And then crash a good 40 degrees behind this front. This is a strong front.
Yeah, it really will. I mean, all you have to do is look at a place like Buffalo. And we're 33 degrees right now. I mean, we're just days away from April. And it is really, really chilly. You can see thin amounts of snow here. And a little bit of snow off the lakes here around Superior. and Lake Michigan as well. So here we go around Mackinac City down to Traverse City. We've got a little bit of snow here at Cleveland. It's right along the water. The roads are looking good, right along the lake, right along the highway there, I-90. We're looking fine. Buffalo, we've had some snow coming for us. Clarence over to Batavia, we've had the snow. And how about Rochester? Look at campus here.
Wow.
Oh, the Yellow Jackets or White Jackets Day. It is not fun, especially when you get hints of spring and there's no snow on the ground, really.
Yeah, you got people walking down those sidewalks, though. You feel for them on a day like this.
You do, especially when you consider it's 34 degrees. It's like, oh, man, I got to go to class. It's like, oh, I feel for you. We've all been there before.
Unless you're Mike, then you would have just skipped class and not
Yes, I would have.
Yeah, just done.
That's why I was your solid B minus C plus student. All right, there's a look at the colder regime setting in behind us here. Thus, we've got a little bit of lake-enhanced snow, but the cold air certainly brings us the snow here across the Northeast through tomorrow afternoon. And then eventually, it all becomes more of a lake event thing than it does become an I-95 thing.
All right, snowfall totals light, but it's still snow as we head towards April. Viv, over to you.
All right. Well, let's talk about the temperature divide, because as we look at the weekend, we are definitely talking about some cold conditions over the east and then the warm up, of course, across the west. Downright hot for many areas over the southwest. Here we go. The nation divided. Afternoon highs a good 15 to 25 degrees above average over the west with a big ridge of high pressure. But with that passage of the cold front that Mark and Mike were talking about, notice these afternoon highs over the east, 15 to 25 degrees below average. Cases in point. We'll start with Atlanta. Your average afternoon high is about 67 degrees, but check it out, going through the weekend, in particular on Saturday, only 54. That's almost 15 degrees below average. On the other side of the coin, though, we'll be heating it up for sure in Los Angeles tomorrow. Today, perhaps low 90s, by the way, and then getting slightly cooler on Sunday, but still well above average, with the average high being 71. Here's another case in point. Chicago, you will be below average. Look at the forecast high tomorrow, only 29 degrees in Chicago. As Mike and Mark mentioned, we talk about a very potent cold front pushing through and just barely above freezing on Saturday in Chicago, but a lot different in the Phoenix, Arizona area, mid-90s going through the weekend. Back to you, Mark.
Thanks, Viv. And we head back to Oklahoma next, still looking at the death and destruction in the wake of those storms. Headed back to Moore live for an update as crews begin to assess that cleanup process.
Currently in our area, 83 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, thunderstorms with locally heavy downpours. High 84. 1 to 2 inches of rain expected. Tonight, thunderstorms early. Low 72. Chance of rain 80%. Friday, afternoon thunderstorms developing. Windy. High 91. Chance of rain 60%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
All right, right now on Weather Center Live, we are still following the search, the recovery, and the cleanup happening across Oklahoma.
In fact, more than 150 severe weather reports yesterday, 7 reported tornadoes, 1 fatality, numerous injuries, for most, a big, unexpected mess.
That dropped out of the sky. Everybody was tracking the tornado that was going over El Reno out in Yukon at the time. And my family and I were going to dinner. And we drove over the bridge. We saw a police car go by us about 80 miles an hour with lights and sirens on, and another went by about 90 miles an hour with lights
goodness.
And sirens.
Sure.
And it's like, then the third one went by, it's like, uh-oh, something's happened.
Then, I hear you.
Then it came on the radio. There's a tornado on the ground, and we looked over to our right, and there it was.
Our focus today is after the storm, giving you a firsthand look at the devastation and destruction. Plus, we're making sure you know what's happening now, what's still coming today. Our expert-filled, in-depth, live coverage starts right here, right now, on Weather Center Live. And a good Thursday to everyone. Thanks so much for watching us and joining us here as Weather Center Live rolls on. I'm Mark Elliott.
And I'm Vivian Brown. Now, during the show today, we're going to Oklahoma as parts of the state deal with death and destruction from yesterday's tornado outbreak. Let's begin in Tulsa.
Yeah, crews there dealing with extensive damage. You can see behind us the downed power lines, the toppled trees, homes that were destroyed as those storms came in.
Definitely a scene of tragedy that will no doubt take weeks and months to recover and get back to normal.
Yeah, and this is a view that you absolutely have to see. This is one of the most shocking videos I've seen in a long time, partially because this is from a helicopter that's flying during these storms. KFOR sent this in to us. But in the distance there, you see those flashes? Those are power arcs, maybe some of the substations getting involved, debris of some kind hitting the lines, or the lines actually snapping and breaking as the storm rolled through. Just an unbelievable view, and we're going to go in depth on this video and others as the show continues. First, let's go to Viv now with the latest.
Well, here is the very latest on yesterday's severe weather. More than 160 reports of severe weather across six states, seven tornado reports, one tornado fatality at the Sand Springs Mobile Home Park. More Oklahoma, the public schools there are closed today. One elementary school's roof is missing. And state officials say at least nine people were hospitalized with injuries across the state. Let's check in now with meteorologist Mike Seidel. He's in Moore, Oklahoma.
Yeah, Mike, let's talk a little bit about what happened yesterday, because it's definitely not something new to the good people of Moore, but it was a rough start to this tornado season.
Yes, to go all month without a twister in the lower 48. We've never gone this deep in March, Mark and Vivian. And then it happens, of all places, here in Moore and then up the road in Tulsa. They've had a checkered past. The cleanup is underway. The rebuilding process actually getting underway. This house lost its roof. They're now taking the boards up there, the particle board. They've also got the blue tarp up there to keep any future rain out of the house. Fortunately, it's going to be dry for the foreseeable future. And if I never see another blue tarp during my job here at the Weather Channel, I'd be a happy camper, because, you know, it's just a sign that there's been problems, whether it's severe weather or tropical weather. And across the street, they've already got the felt up here on this house, so they're making big progress. And I suspect they'll get that roof up today. And look, the guy's putting up, trying to get that part of his under his front door back up, the pylon there with the house address 238. As Mark mentioned, Moore has seen plenty of tornadoes, and this is basically a town that's like a tornado magnet. Here are the tracks. We're going back to the late 90s. We were here for the F5 back in May 3rd of 99. That was the so-called Moore Bridge Creek tornado. 36 perished in that one, over 350 injuries. Then the F4 4 years later, and then just 2 years ago on May 20th, we had the EF5 here in Moore that killed 24. And the winds on that one were clocked, estimated at 210 miles an hour. Again, in retrospective, this one is a far cry from those monsters. But the homeowners, as we spoke to this morning, are just happy to have help cleaning up this mess.
Some of these guys from the Air Force have never even seen, you know, a tornado. And there's guys out here going, wow, what is this all about? Guys from New York, guys from Massachusetts, girls from everywhere. So, and I mean, to have this kind of thing show up again and more is just amazing.
It's always good to have everybody pitch in, friends, neighbors, folks just showing up, doing their good deed, even on a day where a lot of folks have to go to work. Vivian, Mark, sunny, near 50 now, a far cry from yesterday's 84, but we're going to be back in the 70s. And as I mentioned, no rain in the immediate future as the cleanup continues here in central Oklahoma.
All right, Mike, thanks so much for the update. And that's what we hear. As the weather gets at its worst, the community is at its best. But my goodness, what a day yesterday. 160 severe reports, several tornado reports, about seven. There's the one outside Oklahoma City in Moore. And here's a look at the storms as they roll towards Moore. This one in particular is the tornadic producing storm came right on through. Here's another view for you. Follow this from just south of El Reno, straight on down across the highways and into Moore. Good news is that these storms will be significantly weaker today, but there are still some storms, especially near the Gulf Coast. So let's get an update on what's happening today and where you have to be on guard. Mike Betta standing by in the lab. Mike, what are you watching?
Yeah, nailed it on the head there, Mark. It's definitely the Gulf Coast, the area that we're focused on today. In particular, Florida getting hit pretty hard right now between Pensacola and Panama City. So we're going to take you there and show you kind of set up in the atmosphere. A little bit different than yesterday. We don't necessarily have the wind shear that we had yesterday. We have more general areas of thunderstorms, and then cold air is going to replace notice everything as this front sweeps on through. So on the front side of our cold front, we've got warm south-southwest air. On the back side, a cold north-northwest wind. And so two different air masses here in two different scenarios. Look at this big, large swath of rain rolling through Louisiana, Mississippi, Alabama, hitting us pretty hard right now down through Florida. Look at all the lightning embedded with it as well. Dangerous place to be is out on the beach right now trying to get a view of this. A lot of spring breakers down here around Panama City. We've got some real issues there. Let's take you to Panama City and show you what it looks like right now. No one out on the beach, and probably for real good reason. We saw the thunderstorms there. It is raining to beat the band. We'll see rainfall rates here in the squall lines of up to an inch an hour, but not a fun time to be out there in Panama City, at least right now. And it looks like tomorrow will be a much better day. There's a look at the forecast through the day. Temperatures are mild, but notice thunderstorms every single hour through this evening. This evening, we're going to taper off the thunderstorms, more or less rain, but it's probably a movie day for you here. Storms extend back through Hampton Roads, by the way. There's a look at our front and its progression here. Cold air on the backside, a little bit more tranquil air, but very, very chilly. Temperatures will trend 15 to 20 degrees below average for much of the East Coast through tomorrow. That's look what's going on. We're going to talk more about what happened in Oklahoma yesterday. We return you to the scene next on Weather Center Live.
15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Everybody knows that, Parker.
Well, did you know auctioneers make bad grocery store clerks?
It'll be $23.50. Now $75, $23.75. Hold on, I'm hitting it now, $23.75, $24. Hey, $24, $24 and a quarter, quarter. Now half, $24 and a half, and $75, and $25. Now a quarter, hey, $26 and a quarter. Hold on, I'm hitting it now, $20. You want to do it? $5 and a quarter. Sold to the man in the khaki jacket.
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
It tastes better when you grow it. It tastes even better when you share it. It's not hard. It's doable. It's growable. Get going with Growables. Miracle-Gro. Life starts here.
Are you a man over 40 and feeling tired, losing muscle, have less romantic drive? Then you need Ageless Male, with an ingredient clinically shown to increase free testosterone levels. Ageless Male is now available at these fine retailers.
The FDA issued a public notice to doctors and patients concerning serious injuries caused by transvaginal mesh, bladder mesh, pelvic sling, and bladder sling. Please call now if you had one of these devices implanted in the last 5 years. You may be entitled to a cash award. If you had a transvaginal mesh, bladder mesh, pelvic sling, or bladder sling in the last 5 years,
please call 1-866-686-7952 now.
But now, let's put this out here.
I'm getting soaked. We're getting a good heavy hit of rain.
We have been shattering records. Look at this, Sam.
Thanks for watching AMHQ and helping to make us the fastest growing major network on cable. AMHQ on the Weather Channel.
You weren't expecting that, were you?
No, I wasn't.
Currently in our area, 83 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, thunderstorms with locally heavy downpours. High 84. 1 to 2 inches of rain expected. Tonight, thunderstorms early. Low 72. Chance of rain 80%. Friday, afternoon thunderstorms developing. Windy. High 91. Chance of rain 60%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Sundays.
One man's trash
did the work.
This is another man's totally awesome beer can space heater.
Hi.
Brainstormers. Sundays at 9, only on the Weather Channel.
Incredible. I've been Claritin Clear for 10 days.
When your allergy symptoms start, doctors recommend taking one Claritin every day of your allergy season for continuous relief.
With powerful 24-hour non-drowsy Claritin, live Claritin Clear. Every day.
Now everyone who uses catheters can get a better catheter with Liberator Medical's free catheter sample pack. These new catheters are better than ever. Easier to use, more convenient, comfortable, virtually pain-free. Don't wait. Call now and get your free catheter sample pack. There's the all-new compact catheter for women. Pre-lubricated, no drips, no mess. Fits in your purse. The self-lubricated catheter. It lubricates itself in the package. Comfortable, no mess. The closed system catheter, pre-lubricated with its own collection bag, proven to reduce UTIs. The discreet pocket catheter, curved to fit in your pocket to go anywhere. The polished eyelet catheter for micro-smooth comfort, reduces friction and pain. Call now. We'll also bill Medicare and your insurance for you. Call for your free catheter sample pack with free shipping. Call Liberator Medical.
Call 1-800-601-3450. That's 1-800-601-3450.
Here it is, tornado on the ground, west of Sand Springs, about 5 miles. Big tornado on the ground. Time is 5:35.
Intense moments for sure yesterday evening. Professional storm chasers getting up close and personal the view of the deadly tornado. Now, if you ever find yourself in a situation like this, please run for cover. Seek shelter in a sturdy building away from all windows on the lowest floor.
And of course, we continue to get in some pretty amazing video. We do want to share it with you. We're going to put this video up behind us, and the first of which is underneath one of those classic overpasses where we tell you not to go because it actually funnels the wind and the debris right to where these cars are hanging out. And look how that van is rocking, Viv.
Yes, and you said debris, but you can see all of the little darker spots there. That's debris just floating and flying in the air, which could be definitely deadly even.
Yeah, and we're gonna talk to the storm chaser that shot this video coming up in about 5 minutes. So don't go anywhere. We definitely wanna hear what he was thinking when this was occurring.
All right, but in the meantime, we wanna take you back to this very scene of yesterday, the tornado. Our own Ron Blome joins us now live from Sand Springs.
Ron, a lot of damage behind you. Have you gotten any sense of what the people in the area are thinking about and feeling today, the day after the storm?
Well, much as Mike Seidel was saying of Moore, Oklahoma, cleanup is now the order of the day here. I think people are feeling lucky that they just lost things instead of people. Of course, there was the loss of one life and three injuries across the river. This is where the tornado touched down. I'm going to give you a 180-degree view here of what's going on. We've got a lot of contractors that have kind of poured into the area, insurance adjusters as well, and people who are just coming in to take a look. But take a look at the way the metal is just wrapped into the trees here and all the debris. And as we pan around, you'll see that the owners of the donut store are walking through the debris looking for pieces. And all of that massive pile in the trees out front, that is most of the Daylight Donut Store that was ripped off its foundation when we started, and it's now over there. We're also seeing a big influx of utility crews. They actually had some utility contractors who are out here building a new transmission line, and so they've been pressed into service to restore power. Now, at the height of the storm, there were some 80,000 customers had lost service. They moved that number down very rapidly. It's now well below 20,000, and they're hoping to get some big circuits on. But the big circuit overhead of us, it had a lot of this wrapped aluminum around it, and it was touching two wires. So these big high tension lines that run right along this road here where the tornado touched down are still not been activated as they try to clean all of this up. Across the river course is the mobile home park. Residents are being allowed in this afternoon to try to go through their possessions. Some of them were a little upset this morning. They couldn't get after that task early on, but officials wanted to make sure that the area was indeed safe and all of the leaking gas lines had been cut off. Vivian, that's the story here. Back to you.
All right. Thanks very much, Ron. As you saw, the sky is bright and blue. We have lots of sunshine for the rest of the day for the cleanup efforts in the Sand Springs area, right on through the 7 o'clock hour. The only caveat, it's a little breezy with those winds out of the north and west. But here's a look at the extended forecast each day, right on through the weekend and the beginning of next week. We talk about mostly, partly to mostly sunny conditions, and temperatures will remain pretty consistent. actually getting pretty warm on Sunday with an afternoon high of 75 degrees. Back to you, Mark.
And Viv, we have some breaking news we want to share with everyone right now. Behind me, a tractor trailer truck that was blown over in Dallas. Yes, the winds are blowing strong behind the cold front that was associated with the severe weather yesterday. Those strong north winds ushering in the new air mass for the East Coast, but it's also giving us extremely strong winds through the plains with that broadside of a truck. Those winds are strong enough to make it overturn on the highway. So be careful, especially in the high profile vehicles today.
Don't let a severe cold hold you back. Theraflu medicine breaks you free from your worst cold and flu symptoms. It has the power of three medicines to take on your worst pain and fever, cough, and nasal congestion.
Okay, guys, it's getting late. You gotta hit the road.
Millions of people count on the Weather Channel.
Good morning, guys. Let's get the live shot set up.
That's why the Weather Channel counts on Theraflu products. Theraflu, serious power.
At the end of the day, my hands are beat up.
Especially during the winter times, hands are splitting, cracking, making it very difficult to do my job.
O'Keefe's Working Hands. Guaranteed relief for dry hands that crack and split.
Best stuff we've ever used.
It just works.
Learn more at workinghands.com.
When you're hungry for the craveable taste of tender fish and shrimp, nothing's better than Long John Silver's. Now, for a limited time, enjoy our new crispy golden fish and shrimp basket for just $3.99 at Long John Silver's.
My husband said, you're beautiful and I love you, but I'm worried about your health and your weight. I'm worried we're going to lose you. That was my moment.
When your moment comes, you can count, track, and worry over every meal. Or you can lose weight simply with Jenny Craig.
Just walk in or call. Meet your dedicated personal consultant who helps you reach your goals. Pick out delicious food and start losing now. Visit JennyCraig.com for our best offer ever.
A moment can change your whole life with Jenny Craig.
This is my story.
This is my journey.
This is the future of the game.
We are going to Augusta National.
The Drive, Chip, and Putt National Finals. April 5th at 8 a.m. Eastern on Golf Channel.
For the tire selection that rules the road, get to Tire Kingdom Spring Savings Event. For a limited time, buy four select in-stock tires. Get $100 off instantly. Goodyear, Cooper, Continental, Yokohama, and more. Plus, get additional mail-in rebates on these top tire brands. Buy four tires, get $100 off instantly. Tire Kingdom Service Centers. That's all you need.
One look at that Red Baron pizza and you're gonna love it from the first bite to the last. Because a perfect pizza requires a perfect crust. The sauce commands your attention. The cheese begs you to savor every bite. The pepperoni declares you have reached pizza nirvana. And that last slice?
What's it worth to you?
A perfect crust means a better pizza. Red Baron, love at first bite. Pick up a pizza you can call your own. Red Baron Singles.
Sundays.
One man's trash.
This is perfect.
Is another man's wood-powered Jeep gasifier.
Brainstormers. Sundays at 9, only on the Weather Channel.
Stay tuned for your local on the 8, brought to you by Disney Parks.
Home with Dad.
Thanks, buddy.
Does he know what he's doing?
He knows what he's doing.
Ready, Star Command. Prepare for launch.
This should be good.
To infinity! And beyond!
We all have a Disney side.
Everyone in the car, let's go get them.
And the best place to show it is Disney Parks. So come to the place where the entire family can laugh, let loose, and play together. Disney Parks. Come on, it's time to show your Disney side.
Currently in our area, 84 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, thunderstorms with locally heavy downpours. High 84. 1 to 2 inches of rain expected. Tonight, thunderstorms early. Low 72. Chance of rain 80%. Friday. Afternoon thunderstorms developing, windy. High 91. Chance of rain 60%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Getting new pictures. In fact, these are live shots courtesy of K4TV showing the destruction in Moore, Oklahoma. Moore, the 7th largest city in the state with some 55,000 people. And look at the widespread destruction that we were dealing with from a tornado of yesterday. We've had reports of roofs blown off of some homes. And this is so broad of a view that you really can't see the true destruction, but it was a tornado that moved through the area yesterday, and widespread damage was reported.
Yeah, one thing to notice on these wider views are the blue colors in the distance. Mm-hmm. Almost without a doubt, those are blue tarps on top of people's roofs, a sign that repairs have begun in the area today, but also a sign that people need to go through those repairs. There's one of those blue tarps right in the center of your screen now, the top of your screen. There's another one. We're zooming in for you. Mm-hmm. So yeah, lots of roof damage. That seems to be the general theme across this area of Moore. These are people's homes. One of the biggest damaged buildings for Moore was one of the schools, and it's one of the reasons why all the schools are closed today in Moore.
But the thing about it is that it does show that we do have some blue tarps, but it just shows the disparity of this storm because, you know, many homes still have their roofs on them as
yeah,
well.
Yeah, pretty typical pattern for these tornadoes. Some houses will get hit, others right next door won't at all, and that's part of the dynamics of the storm. And speaking of the dynamics of that storm, we want to bring in someone who was in this storm, or really close to this storm, I should say, at this time yesterday.
And this is Scott Peak. He's a storm chaser. Now, Scott, you got a chance to actually witness some of this. Tell us what you actually saw.
Yes, well, I was in Sand Springs, Oklahoma, on a supercell that was producing a tornado in that area near Tulsa, and intercepted a large cone tornado in that part of the state.
And so we're watching your video right now. We can see that your chase vehicle is, I believe, underneath an overpass with several other cars. What was going through your head at the time?
Well, we misjudged the speed and the distance of the tornado as it was approaching the location. The only option we had was the overpass. No other building like that was hit through. It's sheltered. The overpass.
And we can actually see debris just flying all over the place, and we can even hear the winds. I'm sure you were frightened. You were extremely frightened, weren't you?
I was keeping my cool, but I was also trying to stay aware of the situation and not in that situation. So.
And tell us a little bit about the storm itself. As you went under that overpass, it seemed like it almost surprised you as to how close it actually was to in front of you crossing the road. And then you had all the debris kind of changing directions back and forth. Just give us a play-by-play. What were you thinking when this was happening?
Well, I was thinking, okay, well, the tornado is going to go over the overpass, but instead it went right in front of us. So when I saw the tornado doing that, I realized we were pretty safe at that point on. Which I was a little shocked about. I thought it was going to go behind.
And it was right at dusk, too, so the mere fact that it was getting darker, I'm sure, it added to the uncertainty of it all, right?
Oh, yes, it sure did. And the 20 was also rain-wrapped. I forgot to mention that.
Mm-hmm. All right, a scary situation, but glad you are okay, and glad that the people with you underneath that overpass were okay as well. So thanks for your time today, Scott. And, you know, we do want to go back to those live views from KFOR over Moore, a zoomed-in view there briefly of some of the damage in the distance.
Oh, yeah, with a zoomed-in view, you can clearly see the destruction of this tornado. Again, we were following it yesterday. We had the bullseye right in central Oklahoma, and atmospheric conditions were coming together for the threat of severe weather. Even though it was a slow start, it was very active yesterday, unfortunately.
We'll break down more video from the storms yesterday when we come back.
This program brought to you by Brother. Brother at your side. Learn more at don'tsupersizeoptimize.com.
Sometimes bigger is better. But other times, bigger just gets in the way. At Brother, we know the biggest printer isn't always the best fit for every office. So we've come up with a bigger idea. Don't supersize, optimize. See how we can help you put the right printers in all the right places and help reduce your costs. Now that's big. Brother, at your side. Learn more at don'tsupersizeoptimize.com.
Ugh, heartburn.
Did someone say burn? Try Alka-Seltzer Relief Chews. They work just as fast and are proven to taste better than Tums Smoothies assorted fruit.
Mmm, amazing.
Yeah, I get that a lot.
Alka-Seltzer Heartburn Relief Chews. Enjoy the relief.
She watched him being tortured and killed. Ah! Moment by moment.
You think he's coming back?
I know he is.
Barry, he's alive.
Where is your son?
Not here. There's so much pain and despair. That's why my son came to us. To free us from it.
AD, the Bible continues. Easter Sunday, April 5th on NBC.
You know your dentures can move. Unlike natural teeth, try Fixitin Plus TrueFeel. The smooth formula helps keep dentures in place. It's free of flavors and colorants for a closer feeling to natural teeth. Fixitin and forget it.
Oh, cool. I can check my credit score on Credit Karma.
Checking your credit score is for chumps.
I have great credit.
How do you know?
Duh.
You know those change, right?
Tattoos don't change.
Try Credit Karma. It's free, and you can see what your score is right now. Aren't you a little bit curious?
I just got my free credit score!
Credit Karma. Really free credit scores. Really free.
I've got to update my ink.
Hut, hut! When it comes to losing weight, everyone has a number. And if you want to get your performance back and feel great, do what I did. One call and I lost it all. 22 pounds gone.
Lose weight fast with Nutrisystem's Fast 5 Plus Kit. Lose 5 pounds in your first week, plus 1 inch off your waist or your money back, guaranteed.
Nutrisystem has everything you need to feel better, look better, and perform better at any age, faster than ever before.
I haven't felt this good in years. Thank you, Nutrisystem. I lost 8 pounds in the first week.
Order your 28-day Nutrisystem plan right now, including Fast 5 Plus. Get 1 week of meals, plus 1 week of energizing shakes and Craving Crusher shakes, free. New food selections, new expert guides. Call now and lock in 2014 prices, and shipping is free.
Whether your number's 10 or 50, make the right call. Nutrisystem.
Call 855-789-THIN now and lose your first 5 pounds fast.
But now, let's put this out here. I'm getting soaked. We're getting a good heavy hit of rain.
We have been shattering records. Look at this, Sam.
Thanks for watching AMHQ and helping to make us the fastest growing major network on cable. AMHQ on the Weather Channel.
You weren't expecting that, were you?
No, I wasn't.
Currently in our area, 84 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, thunderstorms with locally heavy downpours. High 84. 1 to 2 inches of rain expected. Tonight, thunderstorms early. Low 72. Chance of rain 80%. Friday, afternoon thunderstorms developing. Windy. High 91. Chance of rain 60%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Never know what's going to happen.
Woo! That was a good one.
It's hard to believe that 2 years later we're back at a Moore public school surveying damage. I am very thankful that the school did not receive this damage during school hours, that it happened at night when people were in their homes, or we're thankful that no children received any injuries at this particular site.
Moore and Sand Springs, Oklahoma, two cities now dealing with the aftermath of deadly tornadoes. Thanks for joining us on Weather Center Live. I'm Vivian Brown. Watch and listen to this video. Now, this is a tornado that formed and moved through the town of Sand Springs.
There it is, tornado on the ground, west of Sand Springs, about 5 miles. Big tornado on the ground. Time is 5:35.
Heading southeast, southeast.
Zoom out. It's all the way. I'll zoom in just a touch.
Slow contrast. Crossing the Arkansas River.
Let's go to the lab now and bring in meteorologists Mark Elliott and Mike Bettis, as they were a part of our tornado track team last year. And we want you to look at this tornado and this video again and share with us some of the things that you see that perhaps the average person didn't see.
Yeah, Viv, and right off the bat, the first thing to notice is that it's not easy to see.
No,
there's
for sure.
A lot of rain and a lot of debris getting thrown around, and that makes it even that much more dangerous.
All right, speaking of that, the semi that flies on by, right? But one thing you'll notice, you kind of look back at this, the tornado, more or less rain wrap, but you kind of get the point. It's somewhere about right in there, right? And you can see the circulation, which is basically the tornado is going away from you, but the circulation is counterclockwise. The front of your screen is going left to right. You can see the debris here, and you can see the winds clearly are moving in this direction.
Yeah, a good view from over here, from this view, you can see the everything is just kind of racing towards from left to right on the screen.
A lot of pieces of debris, so this is more or less rain wrap, Mark. We've got a lot of debris. You can see the kind of the debris cloud is toward the bottom of this whole thing with the funnel up above it, kind of in this direction, right, like that. So it's tough to see, and when storm chasers are out there, rain wrapped is the enemy.
Yeah, a dangerous situation, that's for sure. So that's the one video of that rain wrapped tornado. This is probably the most impressive video I've seen in a while.
Okay, so a lot of wind. Hard to tell if there's actually a tornado in there or not. You can actually see maybe a larger circulation and brief little sub-vortices that touch down, but power flashes constantly. So you've got debris that's hitting the power lines. It's arcing, causing those flashes, or power poles that are actually falling down.
Yeah, this is from KFOR. This is from a helicopter. So they are up and flying and good distance from the storm.
There was right there quick little vortex right in there, but you can see there are pieces of debris that are flying all over, suspended up in the air. So we've likely got some pretty strong updrafts and some rotation, and look at those big power flashes.
And they're following this just down the line. You have these huge lines of power grids, and they're just one in a row flashing again and again across this area. And my goodness, when it gets towards one of the transformers or the substations, you get one of those bigger flashes.
Oh, for sure. You just look at this, Mark. Right there's the highway.
Yeah.
They have no idea what's going on the other side of that tree line there with all the power flashes that are going on. But obviously, if you're driving through that, you're feeling the wind. If you're not exactly in the middle of the circulation itself.
It appears that at some point these must have to cross the road. They can't stay parallel forever, I suppose. So like they're driving around and just seeing those flashes. My goodness, what a drive.
And so we have tens of thousands without power still this morning.
A lot to clean up to go, Viv. And that's just one of the views that we got into us here at the Weather Channel.
All right. Thanks very much, guys. Well, we want to take you back to Moore, Oklahoma now. That's where meteorologist Mike Seidel is located.
Vivian, this is the kind of day that you're thankful for when friends and neighbors and volunteers show up. We've got cadets from the Air Force Academy here in Moore. We got a bunch of them. We've got Sage Cunningham. He's the de facto leader in charge. And they were building houses for humanity, and they made a decision yesterday to come out here after the tornado hit late yesterday and help these neighbors here in Moore clean up. What can you tell us?
We're out here today. We were building houses all week, but our help was better suited here, helping cleaning up the damage from the tornado and the storm yesterday.
So you had an option of spring break to go to the beach, go home, but you stayed in you left Colorado, came out here to Oklahoma to build houses, and then this happens, and you're out here helping, and everybody seems to be very, very impressed, very happy that you guys showed up.
Yeah, we're all very fortunate, very happy to be here. There are a lot of people at the academy who actually even wanted to come out here and volunteer. volunteer with us, but we can only take so many, so we're all very happy to be out here and helping out with the relief.
And how's this make you feel? How's this make you feel to be out here today helping these poor folks and more of who've been hit over and over again by tornadoes?
I'm actually from Oklahoma, so I wasn't able, 2013 I went out to Colorado to the Air Force Academy. I wasn't able to help with any of that huge storm that came through, so it's really cool to be back in my home state and do all the help we can with my friends from school.
And what's your name?
Meredith Garrett.
Meredith Garrett from the Air Force Academy. And from where in Oklahoma?
Oklahoma.
Okay, good shout out there. How about you gentlemen over here? I didn't mean to block you earlier. What's your take? Who's the meteorologist in the book? Okay, step forward. Okay, Mr. Meteorologist. So give us your take on the storms yesterday. Because were you out working or had you already stopped for the day when the storms hit?
So the severe weather that happened here was last night after we were done working on the houses. So I was actually, my brother lives in town, so I was at one of his friend's house. We were watching, we had 2-inch hail where we were, got some decent pictures of that, but just watching it come down, I was actually trying to text this group being like, hey, see some circulation, you know. Yeah. They're in Norman, so see some circulation more, try to warn them of it. But
and what's your name?
I'm Tim DeRoche.
Tim DeRoche, where are you from?
I am from Fairhaven, Massachusetts.
Oh, back east. So back you missed east. All the snow this winter, huh?
Yeah, I was pretty fortunate, but, you know, tried to warn them, too.
Okay, there you go. There you go, Vivian. We've got a meteorologist, and thank goodness for your help out here, the Air Force Academy, and the military and the cadets out here today helping the cleanup here in Moore, Oklahoma. Vivian, Mark, back to you in Atlanta.
All right, everyone coming together trying to help with the recovery. Thanks very much, Mike. Well, from a look at the aftermath of yesterday's tornadoes to a look at the forecast for today, let's go back to the lab with storm specialist Mike Bettis to tell us more about what we're expecting today, Mike.
Well, some pretty strong storms down along the Gulf Coast this afternoon, Vivian, that's for sure, and actually some of those that have even gone severe. So we're going to touch on what's going on there and kind of the pattern, how it's all set up across the eastern United States. Large area of thunderstorms from Texas all the way up into Cape Cod, way up here in Massachusetts. We'll have some opportunities for some thunderstorms. But notice here from Florida, the Panhandle, large area of severe thunderstorms that are producing some lightning, and then a severe thunderstorm down here in deep south Texas, just outside of Brownsville. So right now, severe thunderstorm warning that does include Hidalgo and Starr County that goes until the top of the hour. Large hail, the primary threat, a hail that's approaching almost 2 inches in diameter. We'll put our checker on here and you can see that our hail size is 1.8 inches in diameter. And so we're looking for some large hail that'll come basically northwest to southeast here and include some 60 mile per hour winds as well. But the large area, very heavy rain and lightning here right along Panama City down toward Apalachicola, Pensacola, Mobile. We've been hit as well. Put on the high resolution 3D radar here and you'll give you a really good indication of the towering thunderstorms. They lined up, that squall line coming right through Panama City, working its way over toward, I'll say, Mexico Beach now. But notice as we tilt this, that may have been pretty intimidating as it came right through beach down here, and a lot of folks down there for spring break not happy to see those thunderstorms. Then you line up those storms right back down along I-10 through Pensacola, back through Mobile and Gulf Shores. But everything is basically following along the jet stream here, and the flow more or less is parallel here, the low-level wind and the mid-level wind. So it's more run-of-the-mill thunderstorms than it is tornadoes today, thank goodness. But if you notice on the backside of that, we've got some snow. We take a look at the extreme pattern when we return.
Currently in our area, 84 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. This afternoon, thunderstorms likely, high 84. Winds south-southeast at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Tonight, thunderstorms early, low 72. Chance of rain, 50%. Friday, afternoon thunderstorms developing, windy, high 91. Chance of rain, 60%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Cold with terrible chest congestion. Better take something.
Theraflu Severe Cold doesn't treat chest congestion.
Really?
New Alka-Seltzer Plus Day Powder rushes relief to your worst cold symptoms plus chest congestion.
Oh, what a relief it is.
Here we go!
Brought to you by Alka-Seltzer Plus Cold and Cough.
you're running a business, LegalZoom has your back. Over the last 10 years, we've helped 1 million business owners get started. Visit LegalZoom today for the legal help you need to start and run your business. LegalZoom. Legal help is here.
According to the U.S. Department of Energy, most homes have air leaks and drafts that waste so much energy, it's like leaving a window open in your home all year long. Don't let another year go by. Call Champion Windows at 844-4-CHAMPION. And right now, when you buy two rooms of windows, you get the third room free. Plus, Champion now offers no money down, no payments, and no interest for 12 months. So call 844-4-CHAMPION today. Because every home needs a champion.
It tastes better when you grow it. It tastes even better when you share it. It's not hard. It's doable. It's growable. Get going with Growables. Miracle-Gro. Life starts here.
You know, some people have told me reverse mortgages sound too good to be true. I mean, you get cash out of your home, no monthly payments, and still own your home. There's got to be a catch, right, Jesse? Well, there isn't. It's like any other mortgage, only with reverse mortgage, the loan's paid back when the last borrower leaves the home. In fact, reverse mortgages are based on a notion that President Reagan signed into law over 25 years ago in order to help seniors remain in their homes. If you're 62 or older and own your own home, you may qualify for a government-insured reverse mortgage with AAG that allows you to turn the equity in your home into tax-free cash. And with AAG, there are never any credit score requirements.
Call 1-800-661-0312 now to receive a new free information kit, including a reverse mortgage guide and DVD, personal stories from people like you, and a brand new family guide for children and loved ones, all absolutely free with no obligation.
AAG can help you pay off credit card debt, eliminate monthly mortgage payments, and provide some real retirement security.
Call 1-800-661-0312 today to get your free AAG Reverse Mortgage Information Kit and Bonus DVD.
In the kit, you'll receive a helpful three-part guide. The first will show you how a government-insured reverse mortgage allows you to access the equity in your home as tax-free cash. 500,000 people have already done it. The second booklet contains stories told by people just like you who've had their lives changed forever using a reverse mortgage. And the third guide is full of helpful answers and information for children and loved ones.
Call 1-800-661-0312 now to receive your information kit and DVD, all absolutely free.
They're simply an effective way for folks just like you to get the cash you need to enjoy your retirement.
Call 1-800-661-0312 now to receive your information kit and DVD, all absolutely free. Call 1-800-661-0312 now.
AAG, the best advice for a better life.
You totaled your brand new car. Nobody's hurt, but there will still be pain. It comes when your insurance company says they'll only pay 3/4 of what it takes to replace it. What are you supposed to do, drive 3/4 of a car? Now, if you had Liberty Mutual new car replacement, you'd get your whole car back. I guess they don't want you driving around on three wheels. Smart.
New car replacement is just one of the features that comes standard with a base Liberty Mutual policy. And for drivers with accident forgiveness, rates won't go up due to your first accident. Learn more by calling 1-844-578-3350. Switch to Liberty Mutual and you could save up to $423. For a free quote today, call Liberty Mutual Insurance at 1-844-578-3350. See car insurance in a whole new light. Liberty Mutual Insurance.
Welcome back to Weather Center Live, and how about this picture? My goodness, it is severe clear in Los Angeles today. Crystal blue skies, lots of sunshine, but also lots of heat.
Yeah, severe clear, that's a good way to put it. Afternoon highs today in the low 90s, but again, we do need the rain in the area, but if you just took a snapshot of this picture and took it out of context and perspective, I mean, it's a gorgeous day today.
Yeah, I mean, a lot of people would really like to be in LA for a day like this. People in LA are trying to buy a cloud.
Yeah.
But, you know, our own Dave Malkoff is nearby, and he knows all about that Western heat wave.
Yeah, he's out in Los Angeles soaking up the Cali sun and those 90-degree temperatures. Take a look.
Yeah, a little bit different weather than there is in New York today. Welcome to Universal Studios Hollywood, where the tour is just about to begin under a blazing sun. Keeping cool in LA requires a bit of creativity. You can run through here or put yourself in this shark attack zone.
Oh, maybe they got him.
That is what the Wright family from Northern Oregon chose to do.
Lots of sunscreen.
This ain't Oregon weather. This is the California sun.
And we're used to 65, so all the time.
These are temperatures that are, in some cases, 10 to 20 degrees above average throughout the Southwest.
Wow, look at that.
Universal Studios Hollywood is ready for anything. Portable misting stations are everywhere.
So this is where the movies are filmed, inside buildings like this.
People who live here are used to the hot days, but for the thousands of tourists walking around, the heat can catch you when you're not expecting it.
Mist bottles just to try and stay cool.
They had a flash flood. The $1,000 of water came crashing down the hill.
Isn't that crazy? Pretty amazing movie magic, huh?
And some amazing temperatures, especially if you compare it to what's happening out east.
Need some sunglasses?
Sunglasses aren't just for movie stars on this line.
Yeah, I understand there's a little different kind of weather right here in this section.
That is why the prime seat is the splash zone. Everywhere else, you're fanning yourself. Not our friends, the Wright family. That is definitely a way to cool off, right? Oh, one more? One more? Okay, I think our microphone has become kind of a theme park attraction here. From Universal Studios Hollywood, I'm Dave Malkoff. Back to you guys.
All right, thanks a lot, Mike. Well, I tell you what, we are looking at sunny conditions in L.A. It's a country, of course, divided when it comes to temperatures. On the left, we have the sun and the fun in Las Vegas. But on the right, the clouds, well, they will become a little thicker. And it'll become cooler, too, in the Atlanta area. Here's Mark with a look at that big divide.
Yeah, Viv, there is a big cold front crashing its way across the country. And by this weekend, it helps set up this extreme pattern. We call it an extreme pattern when the jet stream doesn't go due west to east. Instead, it's taking these big turns way up to the north out west and then way down to the south in the east. That ridge is allowing it to be very warm across the western United States, yet very cold because of this trough in the east. This is the setup for the weekend, and it's why we're going to be so far from our average temperatures. So let's talk about that, because we're going to be 15 to 25 degrees below average here in the east. That is quite chilly for this time of year. And then we'll get to the west, where it's going to be exactly the same magnitude, but in the other direction, in the warmth. So for tomorrow, look at this, Atlanta near 60. By Saturday, though, only in the low 50s. That's about 15 degrees below average. Memphis in the 40s, Louisville in the 40s, Philadelphia near 40. And those are your high temperatures. The low temperatures, even worse. You'll be below freezing Saturday morning in Nashville, but look what happens by Sunday morning. The growing season started across the south. Tupelo near freezing, Atlanta at freezing, Raleigh below freezing. There could be some problems with those tender new plants and those flower buds out there. Charlotte, you're going to be right near the record cold. Wilmington, it looks like you will beat the record from 1966 with a low near freezing. And again, out west, it's just the opposite. So warm, upper 80s to low 90s tomorrow. That'll continue into Saturday, too, and we are talking record heat out west, also breaking some records for those western cities.
Ted's morning was not going well, and when his battery light lit up, it went from bad to worse. But a quick pit stop to AutoZone, where they checked that for free, and Ted and his car were back to peak performance. It's called The Zone. And we'll help get you there. Get in the zone. AutoZone.
Never a good day for a bad battery. Get a Duralast battery. Only at AutoZone.
You know your dentures can move. Unlike natural teeth. Try Fixitin Plus TrueFeel. The smooth formula helps keep dentures in place. It's free of flavors and colorants for a closer feeling to natural teeth. Fixitin and forget it.
It's gonna go fast. Hold on.
You just never know what's gonna happen.
Holy f***, this is cold!
We know you can't control the weather, so we build things to harness it.
Woo! That was a good one.
That's amazing, straight above our heads. That's just incredible.
Man, how do we do that? This is where I want to be right now.
Currently in our area, 84 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. this afternoon. Thunderstorms likely. High 84. Winds south-southeast at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Tonight, thunderstorms early. Low 72. Chance of rain 50%. Friday, afternoon thunderstorms developing, windy. High 91. Chance of rain 60%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Hey, buddy, you're squashing me. Liquid wart remover could take weeks to treat.
Embarrassing wart? Dr. Scholl's Freeze-Away wipes them out fast with as few as one treatment.
Freeze-Away!
Dr. Scholl's, the number one selling freeze brand.
We're here today asking kids what their favorite vegetable is.
Kids?
Now we're going to give those same kids Bush's Baked Beans.
Bush's Baked Beans, the vegetable that kids love.
It's March. Time to seize the moment at your local Hyundai dealer. Right now, get a 2015 Elantra for just 0% APR for 66 months. Plus, get $1,500 March bonus cash. Take advantage of these limited-time offers and upgrade to the award-winning Elantra. But hurry, time is running out. The Hyundai Seize the Moment sales event ends March 31st. Seize your Elantra today and get $3,250 cash back.
All right, listen up. Out on that field today, you will be ready for anything. And I want you to always remember, this is the greatest team you will ever be part of.
And when they're asked, what did you do to make a difference in the world? They can say, I became a soldier.
I want my foyer to smell more like a foyer.
I want his bedroom to smell like he's away at boarding school.
Surround yourself with up to 6 hours of luxurious, long-lasting scents. Introducing new Unstoppables Air Refresher.
Hey, girl. Is it crazy that your soccer trophy is talking to you right now? It kind of is. It's as crazy as you not rolling over your old 401k. Cue the horns. Just harness the confidence it took you to win me and call TD Ameritrade's rollover consultants. They'll help with the hassle by guiding you through the whole process step by step. And they'll even call your old provider. It's easy. Even she could do it.
Whatever, Janet.
For all the confidence you need, TD Ameritrade. You got this.
Hey, girl.
Hey, can you help me move?
Sure, but I can't use my hands.
I would, but my back is so bad.
Oh.
Hi, I'm moving.
No problem. The Xfinity Movers Edge program makes it easy to stay connected to your TV, internet, and home phone when you move.
Oh, thank you.
Finally, get some help moving. Get your Xfinity services professionally installed on the date you choose, or ask how you can take your equipment with you. Call 1-855-MOVE-EDGE or go online today.
One look at that Red Baron pizza, and you're gonna love it from the first bite to the last. Because a perfect pizza requires a perfect crust. The sauce commands your attention. The cheese begs you to savor every bite. The pepperoni declares you have reached pizza nirvana. And that last slice?
What's it worth to you?
A perfect crust means a better pizza. Red Baron, love at first bite. Pick up a pizza you can call your own. Red Baron Singles.
Sundays.
One man's trash.
Get the worst.
Is another man's totally awesome beer can space heater.
Hi.
Brainstormers. Sundays at 9, only on the Weather Channel.
Now, we're hearing of amazing stories of survival, too, after deadly storms tore through Sand Springs, Oklahoma, yesterday, including what you're seeing here. Now, a group of 60 young gymnasts inside the Aim High Gymnastics Studio narrowly escaped as a tornado caved the roof right in. We're so happy that everyone was able to get out safely. We're taking you back live to Sand Springs to follow up on the scene there in just a moment. But now we want to check in with Mark Elliott and Mike Bettis. They want to talk about the wintry side of this storm.
Yeah, it's still snowing up towards the north, so this is the time of year, right? We see every season on the map all at once.
Right, you know, and it seems like you get into this part of the country, you know, off of Lake Erie or Lake Ontario, you really can't bank on not getting snow till mid-April.
Yeah, or early May in some cases.
Some cases early May. So we've got the ingredients that are there. We've got a low pressure, fairly wrapped up low that sits here, but you've got the strong north-northwest wind sliding in behind that. So a large cold air mass is really going to take over the eastern half of the country, Mark. We don't have a ton of snow. We've got snow on the backside of our front here, but not a ton of snow. Temperature certainly cold enough to support it, 33 in Buffalo.
Yeah, you know, strong southerly winds out ahead of this warm front. So that's just cranking the temperatures up, but also giving the moisture.
Absolutely.
The
so we've seen temperatures today that'll be in the 70s along the I-95 corridor. But look at this, I-75. You're so cold. Your snow right now getting some enhancement off the lakes here around to Cleveland. Right at the water's edge, you've got the snow. Once you get on land, it's pretty much all rain. The roads look fine in Cleveland right now.
Probably same a cool Brown view, Erie. Though, looking out at the
lake. Absolutely. You probably can't see a whole heck of a lot out there. Buffalo, we've had some heavy snow bands today. We'll see a brief accumulation and work your way, say, over toward maybe the Rochester area. We've seen the snow here, Mark, for the last 2 hours or so, and coming up pretty good here at the campus.
Yeah, still above freezing, so it just goes to show you that it doesn't matter as much what the temperature is right where we're standing as it does in the profile above
us. Right, and the rate's been pretty good. That we do have some dusting here on the grassy surfaces. Sidewalks look pretty good. Roadways look pretty good right now. But there's a big collision of air masses here, as you were alluding to. Very strong, warm flow out ahead of that front. Cold flow in behind. So it's two seasons in one front here and two types of precipitation as well. We'll have the snow through the evening, even tonight, for your drive time and for dinner time. We've got the snow. Then the front side, it's all rain. Should stay that for at least the next 12 to 16 hours. Maybe briefly at times go over to a little bit of snow, but I don't think Boston, Hartford, New York, any of those places are in it, primarily off the lakes through tomorrow morning.
Nice change of the season so that we can talk about Boston and not talk about snow.
Finally.
Just rain for you.
When's the last time we did that?
Yeah, it's been a while. Viv, over to you.
Yeah, so we're not talking about snow, but still some very cold air over the east while it's pretty hot across the west. So the weekend extreme is temperatures is still our other big weather story of the day. Notice for the weekend, afternoon highs will be running a good 15 to 25 degrees below average over the east, but just the opposite across the west. Case in point, in New York City, your average high, about 53 degrees, but look at Saturday, not getting out of the 30s, we don't think, at the most, low 40s for the afternoon high on Saturday, so prepare for that in New York City. But not to worry, the heat is on across the west. Las Vegas, your average high is 73, but you'll be up to 92 on Saturday, a good 20 degrees above average. Much of the same for Cleveland and Denver, just total opposites here. Look at your high on Saturday, Cleveland. Now, this is very impressive. Only 26 degrees when typically you should be at least in the low 50s, and much of the same in Denver. Look at the Mile High City, up to 78 degrees, again, a good 20 degrees above the norm. And last but certainly not least, Atlanta, you too will be on the chilly side of things as your average afternoon high is 67, but going through the weekend, in particular, the start of the weekend on Saturday, only 54, but just the opposite in Los Angeles. Back to you, Mark.
And coming up in about 60 seconds, we're going to go back to Oklahoma, still following up on the destruction and deaths in the area. So we're going there live as the crews begin that process and assess the cleanup. Weather Center Live is back in 60 seconds right after your local on the 8s.
Currently in our area, 83 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. This afternoon, thunderstorms likely. High 84. Winds south-southeast at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Tonight, thunderstorms early. Low 72. Chance of rain 50%. Friday, afternoon thunderstorms developing. Windy. High 91. Chance of rain 60%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Yeah.
Right now on Weather Center Live, it is the search, the recovery, and the cleanup that is happening across Oklahoma.
More than 150 severe weather reports yesterday, 7 reported tornadoes, 1 death, numerous injuries. For most, a big unexpected mess.
Woman dropped out of the sky. Everybody was tracking the tornado that was going over El Reno and Yukon at the time. And my family and I were going to dinner. And we drove over the bridge. We saw a police car go by us about 80 miles an hour, lights and sirens on, and another went by about 90 miles an hour,
lights and sirens. Sure.
And it's like, then the third one went by, it's like, uh-oh, something's happened.
In the area.
Then it came on the radio. There's a tornado on the ground, and we looked over to our right, and there it was.
And there it was. And our focus today is what happens after the storm. We're going to give you a firsthand look at the devastation and the destruction in Oklahoma. Plus, we're making sure you know what's still happening now. Our expert-filled, in-depth, live coverage starts right here, right now, on Weather Center Live. Hopefully everyone near you is okay on this Thursday. It was a dangerous day yesterday. Thanks for sticking with us for Weather Center Live. I'm Mark Elliott.
And I'm Vivian Brown. Now, during the show today, we're going to Oklahoma as parts of the state deal with the death and destruction from yesterday's tornado outbreak. Let's begin in Tulsa.
Yeah, in Tulsa, crews are dealing with extensive damage from the downed power lines, toppled trees, and homes destroyed. You can see some of the views behind us.
Yeah, and as you can see, it's a scene of tragedy that will no doubt take weeks, months to recover.
Yeah, you know what? Here's why we have so many problems with power outages in and around the Tulsa, Oklahoma area. This is from a helicopter from KFOR. Just an incredible shot here. What you're seeing are power arcs along a line, along the power line. So you're seeing those arcs in order. Sometimes the substations or the transformers give you those brighter flashes, but it's likely debris slamming into those lines. My goodness, what a scene. We're going to go in-depth on this video coming up in the next half hour, but there's a lot to cover right now, so let's go to Viv for the latest.
Yeah, let's check in with meteorologist Mike Bettis. He's on the ground Mike Seidel, that is. He's in Moore, Oklahoma.
And Mike, bring us the latest information now. We want to know what people are thinking about today after the storms came through more again yesterday.
Well, they're certainly wondering why they may live in Moore. Many people wonder, hey, why would you live here if you get hit by all these tornadoes? Hey, this is a great part of the country, central Oklahoma. And you know, it's just the odds that this town has been hit by 3 huge tornadoes, actually 4, if you count 99, 03, 2010, and then 2 years ago, that was the EF5. And we have the F5 back in 99 on May 3rd, the Bridge Creek Moore tornado. Yesterday's was a far cry from that. Thank goodness. No fatalities here, but there has been damage, sporadic damage. You ride up and down the streets here. We're just on the west side of I-35, and you can see this house lost its roof. This is about the worst I've seen as far as damage. Again, I haven't seen it all, but you can see what they're up there, the blue tarp, and they're trying to do some reconstruction, but the roof is gone and also the carport. I actually posted the before photo on my Twitter and Facebook page if you want to get a real good idea of what it looked like before and now what it looks like today. Just met a great group of Air Force cadets volunteering for Habitat for Humanity here in Moore during spring break, but yesterday the tornado hit and last night they made a group decision to come out here and do some cleaning up and help out the residents.
And then it's really cool to see the whole community come together, meet up this morning, and there are a lot of people at the community center ready to help. And I mean, it might be dangerous to some, but we're just trying to help any way we can. I think we can do more as a big group than anyone could ever do by themselves. So that's why we're here.
And we thank McKenna Cox and her fellow cadets for coming out to Moore and helping out today. Who needs to be in Panama City getting sunburned where you can just really feel good about coming out and doing a good deed for your neighbors? A lot of those cadets are obviously not from Oklahoma. We did talk to one lady who is from Oklahoma, one of the cadets, but they're here all week helping out Habitat and today helping out the folks here in Moore. On a sunny, beautiful day, it's up to 52. Remember yesterday, 84, our dew points in the upper 50s, and that's what helped the fire these storms. It rolled right through here just after 6:30 yesterday, and now the sounds of the chainsaw falls and the cleanup continue, Mark. But I can tell you, after being here from 99 until 13, all the tornadoes that have come through here, this certainly pales in comparison. And we can be thankful for that today here in Moore. Back to you.
Thanks, Mike. And yeah, Mike referenced that history in Moore, and we're going to show you that real quick. Here's Oklahoma City. Here's Moore. The F5 from 99, the F4 from 2003, and then we get to the EF5 ratings as well as we got right through Moore. This is the red line is the preliminary track from yesterday, and all of this happened within just 3 miles. That's such a small radius and such a history. Of course, it wasn't the only area that had severe weather. 160 severe weather reports yesterday. Here are the tornado reports, and of course the one near Moore, and these are the storms that did it. Follow this as it gets towards Moore. That's the tornado, came right on through, lots of rain behind it, but luckily it is a much quieter forecast now as the cleanup continues undoubtedly into the weekend. It looks like sunny skies. Of course, there's still some storms going on right now, especially near the Gulf Coast where there has been some severe weather. So let's get an update on what's happening right now. Back to the lab. Mike Bettis, what are you watching?
Some pretty strong storms, especially washing down along the Gulf Coast, Mark, and down through Texas where we have some strong storms that are producing some pretty large hail. I'll give you the big picture here. It's the same storm system that produced the violent weather back through Oklahoma yesterday. Everything shifting eastbound, though, not nearly the veracity of the storm as we had yesterday, and I'm not expecting much in the way of tornadic weather today, but down around McAllen, Texas, we do have Hidalgo County and a severe thunderstorm warning right now that does include McAllen, and very heavy hail, very large hail coming right toward McAllen. Hail size estimated to be roughly 3 inches in diameter, so this is a big one here down through South Texas. Got to keep the car in the carport and stay inside. Notice the big storms coming through the Gulf Coast from New Orleans all the way over towards, say, Apalachicola, Florida, Panama City. We had some strong storms come through with a squall line there, letting off just a little bit less force now in Pensacola as well. That's good news. There's a look at Panama City's forecast, staying with the thunderstorms through the remainder of the day and through the night. Tomorrow likely to be a much better day for us in Panama City. A few storms firing up around Hampton Roads as well, around Virginia Beach and Norfolk through the Delmarva. We have some storms for you. Everything in association with this front, strong surge of warm southerly air on the front side, cold surge in the backside, but much calmer air on the backside, but temperatures will trend 15 to 20 degrees colder, but notice will go with the storms through the overnight and early tomorrow morning as well along I-85 and I-95. But one thing you'll notice, a little bit of snow on the backside of that system. We talk about the extremes when we come back and we return you to Oklahoma, the site of the tornadoes from yesterday.
Going to the paint studio at Ace is like going to your neighbor. And hurry in this Wednesday through Sunday for buy 1 gallon, get one free. Save up to $71 when you buy 2 gallons exclusively at Ace.
Ace is the place with the helpful hardware, folks.
You can't always be there to protect her down the road. Make sure the tires she's riding on will. With the revolutionary Michelin Premier Tire, even as it wears down over time, its safety doesn't, thanks to Evergrip technology. The Michelin Premier Tire, safe when new, safe when worn.
This is the new Asian-inspired broth bowl from Panera Bread. Our hero is the soba noodle, which we pair with fresh spinach, mushrooms,
yes,
and chicken raised without antibiotics.
Very nice.
Then top with a soy miso broth. That noise! Panera broth bowls should be slurped with gusto. Yum. To explore further, order online or visit your neighborhood Panera Bread.
I have a cold with terrible chest congestion. I better take something.
Theraflu Severe Cold doesn't treat chest congestion.
Really?
New Alka-Seltzer Plus Day Powder rushes relief to your worst cold symptoms plus chest congestion.
Oh, what a relief it is.
This is my story.
This is my journey.
This is the future of the gang.
We are going to Augusta National.
The Drive, Chip, and Putt National Finals. April 5th at 8 a.m. Eastern on Golf Channel.
Currently in our area, 83 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. this afternoon. Thunderstorms likely. High 84. Winds south-southeast at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Tonight, thunderstorms early. Low 72. Chance of rain 50%. Friday, afternoon thunderstorms developing, windy. High 91. Chance of rain 60%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Sundays.
One man's trash.
This is perfect.
Is another man's wood-powered Jeep gasifier.
Brainstormers. Sundays at 9, only on the Weather Channel.
It took James Dyson 5,000 prototypes to invent the bagless vacuum. And another 10,000 to invent the only vacuum that doesn't lose suction. Thanks to patented sonic tips. Everything else is history. Search Kinetic now.
Dyson's Kinetic Vacuum. The first upright vacuum with Dyson Kinetic Science.
I typed my name. And Ancestry opened the door to the world's largest online collection of family history records. Discover your story today at Ancestry.com.
Nice morning, Scott.
Hi. And a morning of tiny voices crying out,
feed us.
I don't understand.
Your grass, man.
It's a living, breathing thing.
It's hungry, and you've got to feed it with Scott's Turf Builder.
Attaboy, Mikey. Two feedings now in the springtime. Strengthens and helps protect your lawn from future problems.
Get Scott's Turf Builder lawn food. It's guaranteed. Feed your lawn. Feed it.
And to keep crabgrass away all season long, get Scott's Turf Builder with Halt's Crabgrass Preventer.
The Fiat 500 isn't alone anymore. It's part of a big Italian family.
There it is, tornado on the ground, west of Sand Springs, about 5 miles. Big tornado on the ground. Time is 5:35.
Intense moments for sure yesterday evening. These are professional storm chasers getting up close and personal with the view of the deadly tornado. Now, if you ever find yourself in a situation like this, you want to run for cover, seek shelter in a sturdy building away from all windows on the lowest floor.
Yeah, definitely good advice there. Of course, we continue to get in some pretty amazing video sent in to us here at the Weather Channel headquarters, and we want to share it with you.
Yeah, take a look at this video now. You can see some vehicles were parked underneath an overpass as the tornado was going on. And this is what we advise you not to do, because this is not the safest place. You could see all the debris flying around, and actually some of the vehicles even shaking, showing the power of the winds.
Yeah, because of the layout of those overpasses, they actually funnel in the wind. It can be stronger winds underneath those, and thus all the debris gets thrown in at your car as well.
And that debris definitely can become deadly projectiles, and that is why you want to go inside a sturdy building and away from all windows. Now let's take you back to this scene, the very scene of yesterday's tornado.
Yeah, our Ron Blom, along with Keith Carson, have more from Sand Springs, Oklahoma, on how people are coping with the devastation left behind. Guys.
Well, we've been here in Sand Springs since very early this morning. It's a suburb just to the west of Tulsa. It's where the tornado came through yesterday. In fact, the area right behind me where you see all the debris in the trees is where it actually began to touch down. That's the remnants of a daylight donut shop. But then it crosses the river, it gains strength, and it plows through a mobile home park. Now, that park's been closed to the media for most of the day, but my colleague, meteorologist Keith Carson, is just back from a tour. Keith, what was your impression?
Well, you know what? Obviously, there's a lot of destruction in there, and the first thought that we had when we're looking at all these mobile homes destroyed is that the one fatality is, in a way, it's miraculous that that's what it was, because there was just a lot of mobile homes that were ripped right through on top of other things, and some trailers turned over as well. So it's definitely, you know, you see the beginning of it here, but there's less structure to kind of give you an idea of the strength of it as it moved over the river across the mobile home park.
Of course, we know mobile homes don't stand up well to wind storms or tornadoes. Did you see things that told you circulation that it was a tornado?
Oh, yeah. absolutely. I don't think there was any taking this as a straight line wind event at all. I think the question will be just whether what scale it is on the EF. Is it EF1 or 2? It's probably the most early thought on that. But obviously, it did have the circulation of a tornado.
And from the looks here, these trees, they're not broken off low down. As you get close to the river, they're more broken. How about in the mobile home park?
Yeah, they were pretty snapped there as well in most of the spots. They didn't have actually as many trees in the mobile home park itself as they have here. The ones that were there were snapped, I would say similarly to this. Some of the ones that aren't as wide are snapped a little bit farther down.
Yeah. And we know you're going to be reporting more on that, about the Sand Springs tornado and the impact here in Oklahoma. Back to you guys now.
All right, thanks very much, guys. Well, we do have some good news. The cleanup efforts today will be sunny and bright. Now, the only caveat, it's a little windy, a little breezy with those northwest winds, but the temperatures remain inconsistent in the mid to upper 50s, but lots of sunshine and, again, no severe weather. And that will be the case right on through the weekend and the beginning of next week anyway, and actually getting warmer. Look at Sunday's forecast in Sand Springs, Oklahoma, mostly sunny with temperatures in the low to mid 70s. Back to you, Mark.
Thanks, Viv. And, you know, as we go to break, we want to take a look, want you to take a look at some more of this amazing video. This behind me is out of Tulsa, Oklahoma. The video that's being blamed for this is of a tornado that did cause a roof collapse at a gym, and there were dozens of children inside. The good news here is that everyone made it out safely. They did exactly what they were supposed to do and got to the lowest levels and away from the windows. We're breaking down more video when we return.
This little guy is about to make his first deposit.
We'd like to open up a savings account for him.
Yes. Great.
Thanks to Mom and Dad and their safe driving bonus check from Allstate.
Oh, look at this. Safe driving bonus.
Are you a safe driver?
Lucky little fella.
Only Allstate gives you 2 safe driving bonus checks a year for driving safe. See how much more an Allstate agent can do for you. Call 877-644-3100.
Like in most families, Dad's always the last to know. That's why accident forgiveness was the first thing he asked for when he switched to Allstate.
Michael James?
Middle name. Not good.
Get accident forgiveness from Allstate and keep your rates from going up just because of an accident. Find out how a local Allstate agent can help better protect your family. Call one right now. Plus, drivers who switched saved an average of $498 a year.
Just a few more ways the good hands are doing more than ever before.
See what the personal service of an Allstate agent can do for you. Call 877-644-3100.
Can a protein originally found in a jellyfish improve your memory? Our scientists say yes. Researchers have discovered a protein that actually supports healthier brain function. It's the breakthrough in a supplement called Prevagen. As we age, we lose proteins that support our brain. Prevagen supplements these proteins and has been clinically shown to improve memory. It's safe and effective. For support of healthier brain function, a sharper mind, and clearer thinking, try Prevagen for yourself today.
But now, let's put this out here. I'm getting soaked. We're getting a good heavy hit of rain.
We have been shattering records. Look at this, Sam.
Thanks for watching AMHQ and helping to make us the fastest growing major network on cable. AMHQ on the Weather Channel.
You weren't expecting that, were you?
No, I wasn't.
When it comes to Medicare, everyone talks about what happens when you turn 65. But really, it's what you do before that counts. See, Medicare doesn't cover everything, only about 80% of Part B medical costs. The rest is on you.
Consider an AARP Medicare Supplement Insurance Plan insured by United Healthcare Insurance Company. Like all standardized Medicare Supplement Insurance Plans, it could really save you in out-of-pocket medical costs. So call now and request this free decision guide. Discover how an AARP Medicare Supplement Plan could go long for you.
Do you want to choose your doctors? Avoid networks. What about referrals?
All plans like these let you visit any doctor or hospital that accepts Medicare patients with no networks and virtually no referrals needed. So call now, request your free guide, and explore the range of AARP Medicare supplement plans.
65 may get all the attention, but now is a good time to start thinking about how you want things to be.
Go long.
You just never know what's going to happen.
Stay tuned for your Local on the 8, brought to you by Disney Parks.
Happy birthday!
Make a wish, buddy. Okay, now Mom's gonna cut the cake.
We all have a Disney side.
Who wants ice cream?
And the best place to show it is Disney Parks. So come to the place where the entire family can laugh, let loose, and play together. Disney Parks. Come on, it's time to show your Disney side.
Currently in our area, 83 degrees under mostly cloudy skies with windy conditions. This afternoon, thunderstorms likely. High 84. Winds south-southeast at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Tonight, thunderstorms early. Low 72. Chance of rain 50%. Friday, afternoon thunderstorms developing. Windy. High 91. Chance of rain 60%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
I'm very fortunate. I mean, the truck took care of me. It side airbags went off. OnStar called me. I hung upside down until somebody got here and they asked me if I could press the button, and it dropped me then.
It's not the ideal.